My name is Bettina Lotsch. I'm the director of the nanochemistry department at the Max Planck Institute for Solid State Research in Stuttgart since 2017. Before that, I started my scientific career as a professor at LMU Munich. My team and I develop new materials for energy conversion and storage. So we teach materials new trick, for example, to store solar energy in the form of solar batteries or to do photocatalysis in the dark. And to do this, we create new materials that essentially cover the entire periodic table, from organic to inorganic materials or hybrid materials. You know, I have to say that I never really bothered so much about this gender imbalance, and I guess for two reasons. So one reason is that I grew up in a very gender-neutral environment. So gender, in a sense, didn't really matter, but it also was not a problem. And second, you know, at the diploma and PhD level in chemistry, there was not really a gender imbalance there yet. So this kicked in only later, and we're talking about the leaky pipeline. So this is actually becoming an issue only in the later stages of the career ladder. Lonely. Well, just kidding. It didn't matter if you're male or female. What matters is the science. And this is, to my mind, how it should be. So I didn't feel like one of the few female scientists among many male scientists, but I rather felt like a scientist among scientists. But of course, yes, also. So I did also face gender-related difficulties, especially when it came or comes to combining family and a career in science. I realized only just how difficult and challenging it can be to be a full-time scientist and a full-time mother. So on the one hand, it has to do with the pace at which scientific progress evolves simply, and also how the scientific community operates in a sense. There's a lot of time pressure, and there's also a lot of competition for jobs, for funding. And you know, this spirit is not very accommodating or tolerant to career breaks or downtimes in the career. And you know, also, of course, you know, leading your own group is a 24/7 job. So, you know, you cannot easily be replaced like in most other jobs. A situation that, you know, I'm in myself, where, you know, a couple needs to find a common center of gravity at the same institution or at neighboring institutions. And so, you know, this is an area, I would say, where there's a lot of room for improvement. So first and foremost, it is helping me in that it brings together scientists that like me are excited about energy science. And this really kicks off a number of projects that wouldn't have been possible otherwise, simply, you know, for lack of infrastructure, for lack of cooperation, or for lack of opportunity. And this is really, what e-conversion is all about to me. Of course, e-conversion also supports young female scientists a lot. And this, there's a broad repertoire that starts by, you know, providing support for pregnant female scientists, lab support, also by, you know, supporting childcare during conference visits, for example. But there's also a lot that is being done at the graduate level. This is also something that, of course, you know, I encourage my students to participate in. So, for example, workshops or talks that give advice simply in how to develop a career in science, and also, of course, especially for young female scientists. So I think, you know, there's a huge package of support for female scientists within e-conversion, and we hope really that it does the trick.